Hello and greetings from Iceland. This will only be a short update since the situation on the peninsula isn't so complicated now. The biggest surprise of the week was how strong the activity was, but it seems to be powering down now. And this eruption, it could go on for some time more, even weeks. So I am planning my next trip to the volcano in the next few days and use the time to play around with the new camera and more, come up with something different. But it is, however, plenty of footage out there, so it's not as we aren't seeing anything. But as for the technicalities, the ground there is still subsiding, which is hardly a surprise while the eruption goes on so strong. So the inflow is less than the outflow into this magma reservoir under there. But that might even change before the eruption is over. We have seen that before. And it is not until we see land uplift start again that we might get a clear vision into the future. Or is eruption number 10 underway? So yet again, we are heading into a period of uncertainty. And like I mentioned in my last update, the volcanic tectonic chapter by Krafla Volcano was never declared as over since land uplift continued after the last eruption there in 1985. So the inflow there wasn't enough to pressurize the system enough, and my common sense guess as for this eruption is that it might take us a few weeks to see with good accuracy where this is heading, since it has been proven that the inflow into the magma reservoir before this eruption, number 9, it wasn't as stable as before the other eruptions. So there is a little hope there that the deeper magma chamber that controls everything is about to finish its job. But experts have been speaking about one more possible scenario from time to time. Or what if this eruption would develop into a continuous flow from the lower magma chamber without this stopover in this magma reservoir at 4 or 5 kilometers depth? That is the reservoir that has been causing all this uncertainty every few months. And there are experts out there that have mentioned this as a possible scenario, not recently though. And it is of course not for me to say if this is realistic. I'm just coming up with this now because this has been discussed during prior eruptions. And in fact, a continuous eruption would be by far better option than those outbursts every now and then. We would get rid of the uncertainty, or will this magma chamber send us a volcanic eruption or a magma runoff, and we would get rid of those questions where to build those next lava defense walls, not to mention the interruption that all this is causing, closing tourist spots or roads, and even a complete town Grindavík that was very much alive during the first eruption that took place nearby and went on for 6 months. And this is the main crater from that eruption, with the ongoing eruption in the foreground. And if this eruption would go on for even months, where would that leave us? As for the lava, and there are several points of view there. The tourist value is of course excellent. This would be Iceland's next hotspot. The eruption site is however officially closed to visitors now, despite some traffic there. But the authorities are trying to hold the tourists back because it takes a skilled crew of search and rescue workers to be present with their tools, ready to help out. And those who visited the first 3 eruption, they might remember all the staff there, all the volunteers, to keep the place safe. But I don't see the mood for that now. We would need a good trail up there for search and rescue vehicles and such. And if this will be over in a week, that would be just a waste of money. So we are just waiting now. And as for the lava, it's moving slowly to the north, towards the main airport highway. But I seriously doubt that it is going to make it all the way there. It would need way more volume of lava than this eruption is producing now. And I do think that we have plenty of storage space for lava on the middle of the peninsula. So this is something that I'm not very worried about now. But it would however be a loss to see this remarkable area under lava because few other places in Iceland offer so visual tectonic landscape features as this one. or how the fisher swarm makes this strange curve there and tells its own story, way larger than the peninsula. And I will actually talk about this area in my town series video about the nearby village Vogar. And I will mention in that video how the local tourism industry has overlooked this area, or one of the best visuals in the landscape when it comes to plate tectonics. And there are many deep fractures there, with land displacement just as impressive as we see by the tourist plate boundaries in Þingvellir National Park. So when the lava gets closer to this part of the peninsula, it might draw the attention to this curving fissure swarm. And it is quite unbelievable to witness the changes in the landscape after every eruption. And I'm always trying to make sure that I have filmed those locations going under lava, because at some point in time I will film all those areas again from the same angle in order to make the before after footage as good as it can be. In many cases I have footage from many time points, and the reason is that I feel this need to preserve the old landscape on film so the coming generations can see what is under there. And it will be a huge work to do this image blending, because I'm not just filming a couple of angles. I'm talking about an area that covers over 100 square kilometers. And one of my first drone tours with a proper drone in 2022, it covered the Sundhnúkur crater row, where all of those eruptions have taken place. So I got that location and some others right as for what to film before after. But there are of course other cases when I wish that I had turned the drone the other way or hovered a bit longer or closer to some piece of land that is now covered with lava. But this is a priority for me, to capture the changes. The orange stuff, it starts to look all the same in a while. It gets hard to see what came up from what eruption, and it's footage like that all over YouTube. So I'm just trying to deliver more value in the long run, doing my own angles to document the changes and how me and other Icelanders perceived this at any given time, how we felt about this. And during my next volcano visit, most likely early next week, perhaps even Monday, I will of course make some moves with the new camera, the one I meant to tell you about in a video about my channel that is a bit long and needs my attention for one or two more days. But there are other things that require my attention, like when the sun is turning on the spotlight for a few hours after this dull summer that left me with huge pressure to get all my filming done. Videos I need to cover important volcano topics next winter, but there have been good days, so I've been all over the place, filling up hard drives faster than ever before, and overall investing a lot in this long-term project. And since my next tour will not be very carefully planned, it's just about to capture as good light as I can. I can't say when my next update will be online, but the situation by the volcano is in balance and no need to hype that up too much. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.